Hi, my name's Jamie and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today I want to show you how you can split cells in Microsoft Excel. So what I mean is, let's say you have an example like this, first name, last name, and in one cell, and you want to split them to put them in the individual cells like this. I want to show you four different ways that you can do this today in Microsoft Excel. So let's get started right away. This video is following up a video I did on how to combine cells in Microsoft Excel. So I showed six different ways how you can do that. I'll put the link to that video down below in the description and up above in the card. And if you're looking for this worksheet that I'm working on right now, I'll put a link to that down below in the description as well. And you can follow along with the techniques I show you here today. If you look at the different tabs at the bottom of the worksheet, you'll see the different topics, how I'm going to split the cells. The first one is flash fill, very easy to use. And then the next one is going to be the built-in feature text to column in Microsoft Excel, and make sure you're taking advantage of that one. Then I want to show you how you can build a formula to split your cells in Microsoft Excel. And then lastly, I'm going to show you how to do this with Power Query. Now, everything's going to be timestamped in this video, so you can just look in the description and jump to different parts of the video to get to that one way I'm showing you. Let's get started with flash fill first. So flash fill was introduced in Excel 2013, and it's been in all the versions since then. Now, to use this, it's very quick and easy, and it finds a pattern, and it'll kind of happen automatically. Maybe if you noticed it's happening. If I go ahead and if I want to separate Ned Stark into two different columns, if I start just typing the word Ned here, and then I go to the next one. Now, flash fill is going to start to see a pattern, and it's going to suggest a pattern. So if I start typing Cersei, and you can see now I didn't even finish it, but it's suggesting, hey, we found a pattern here, and it's grayed out kind of below. Do I want to accept this? I can hit enter, and you notice there's the flash fill symbol right here. So if you click on this, you can, where you can see undo and everything, where I could have accepted it even without hitting the enter. The other way you can find flash fill, now if I do the end part here and I just type Stark in this one, and I go to the next one. If I take a look up at the data here, notice that flash fill is right here. Since I've typed in the one thing, I can click on flash fill and it quickly kind of just filled it in. And you can see now I have my first name, I have my last name separated into columns. Now I do want to point out, if all of a sudden something changed in this, and so if I was going to go and change it to, just as an example, I'll put an A here. Notice it doesn't update over here, so I'd have to redo these. But that's using flash fill, very easy to use, and you can use flash fill even to combine cells, like I mentioned that in the video that I did about combining cells. Let's move on to the next feature, and that's using the text to column feature. Another easy feature to use is the text to column feature built right into Microsoft Excel. And where you're going to find this is, go up to the data tab, and when we're looking in the ribbon, look over here and we can see text to column. Now what I want to do is highlight what I want to split and go ahead and click on text to column. So when I'm going to click on that, you get a couple different options. For our purposes, I'm going to choose the first one. The other one is more or less if everything was lined up perfectly and the space is always in the same spot, but we're going to use the delimited, and I'm just going to go ahead and hit next. Now in our case, we have a space separator, but if you had a comma in between, you would check comma or semicolon, whatever one pertains to your example. And I'm going to treat consecutive delimiters as one. So if I had the comma and then a space there, which would probably be happening, that's where it's going to help with the split. But it's showing me the preview right down here. I'm going to go ahead and put next. And at this point, I'll just leave it as general. It's showing me the preview down here. Where do I want it to go? Well, it's just going to move it. It's going to actually take, you're not going to see this first column anymore. And then it's just going to break it into the two different columns here. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit finish, and you see it gets quickly done. And that's using the text to column feature that's right under the data tab in Microsoft Excel. So my next way to split cells is using a function or a form and building a formula out of it. And this is probably the most complicated way that will take a little bit more time. But if you go through the process of it, it does have some benefits of using a function or formula. Now, I just want to point out before I get started in building, I kind of want to show you the finished one and explain what's happening. And I'll leave this example in the data sheet too, so you can go ahead and try to copy it down and everything and see if you get it right. But if we look up here in the formula, we have a couple different functions in this first one. So I have the left function. What the left function does, it will start from the beginning of the left side of the cell, and then I'm telling it to search for something inside of this. And what am I telling it to search for? I'm telling it to search for a space. So it finds that space, but then I want to add in -1, because the -1, I don't want the space included. I just want it to be one less than it. So that's how I get the first one for this one. Now, if I click on Start on the last one, you can see now I'm looking at it from the right. So I'm using the right function in this. And here is another function that I'm going to be using, and this is the length. So this tells me how many characters are in this cell. So it would look at this cell over here and then to just would add up how many text characters are in there. And then I'm telling it to do the minus search, what I used before. And what is it looking for? The space. And at this time, you can see it's still referring to the A2, but I don't have the -1 anymore because I don't need the -1 there because it's just where that would start. So those are the two different ones I want to try to explain as I go ahead and create them now. All right, let's start building this out with the first name. I've deleted the formulas that I was just showing you here. It's a formula, so we need to start with our equal sign. And the first function I'm going to start with is the left one. You can see it started to come up here. I'm going to choose this one. Now, if I was just going to use the left function, and I'll show you what it does by itself. If I go ahead, it's asking me what text, what cell, click in here, add the comma. Notice it's saying number of characters. So if I was going to say, if I put in 7 and I just ended this and hit return, what it did is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It gave me that many. If I copied it down, that's what it would give me, the first 7 characters. So that doesn't work what I want. So I'm going to go back to this one here. I'm just going to double click in here and start to edit this. Now, this is where it's important where we have to add the other function, because this is the search one where we're going to be looking for the space between the names. So I'm going to put in search. You can see it comes up there, and I'm going to start to fill in what it's asking for. So what am I looking for? Well, I'm looking for a space. How do I enter in to search for a space? I need to put a quotation mark, actually put a space in, and then another quotation mark, and then a comma, just like this. So now I go back to the click the cell. So within this right here, A2, I'm going to end this with a bracket. And this is where I need to put the -1, because if I don't put the -1, it will actually return with the space. And not that you'll see this space, but I don't want the space in there. So this is why I'm going to put -1 like this and end it. So I'm going to hit enter, and I have Ned, and I can just copy this down into the different cells. So let's now start with the last name. So you might think, well, why don't we take this and copy this and go to this cell and just paste it in and change this to right? And if I do that, you can see it doesn't work. So there's some, if I go ahead and copy this down, definitely doesn't work. So we need to make some changes to this, and this is how we go about it. All right, so I'm going to start with my equal sign again, and this time we are going to use our right function. I'm going to select this. It is going to be just this A2 that I'm going to select on, and notice it comes up with a number of characters here, and it's just like the first example I just showed you with the left. I would just return so many from there. This is where I need to put another function in, and the function is going to be the len function. And I'm just going to, you can see it come up here right here. So this is going to count the number of characters in this cell here. So I'm just going to click on this, And this is where I'm going to put another kind of a formula inside of this. I need to actually minus the search for this. So minus what was I looking for? Well, it was that space. And I'm going to go ahead and just type in search, comes up right here. And this is where I go and have to tell it what I'm searching for. So find the text, and this is going to be using the quotation mark, the space, the quotation mark. And now I'm going to put my comma in, and I'm always referring just to this cell. So that keeps it simple. Just remember when it's asking for the cell, just go back to that cell, and I can go ahead and end this. And I do need to put another bracket at the end because they always have to match, right? So this one matched this one. I'm going to put another one and hit enter. And then I get the last name here, and I can go ahead, copy this down, and this time it works. So again, this can be a little bit more complicated using the formulas, but the nice thing with it is if something changed in here, so as an example, if I type this S in here, return, it's automatically updates. And the other way, whether it be the flash fill or the text to column, those don't automatically update. You'd have to redo the whole thing. So even if you, if you take a little bit more time to create this formula, this is definitely a way you can split cells in Microsoft Excel. So my last example today is using Power Query to split cells in Microsoft Excel. And you might think this might be a complicated one, but it's not really. To use it as the purpose for just splitting cells, and you can combine cells also, and I talk about that in my other video. But if I go, I'm on the fourth tab, and I'm just gonna go to my data tab right up here. And what I need to do is put from table or range. And what it's going to do with this information, this is a range right now, it's going to turn it into a table. So if I go ahead and click on this, where's the data for your table? Well, I'm selected right here. That's not it. It's this right here. I'm going to go ahead and select the, making sure I have the right information selected. My table has headers. It does, because the name is up there. So I'm going to go ahead and hit OK. It's going to open up the Power Query editor now, and you can see it's right in here. So I haven't done anything to this, and what I want to do is split. And you can see right here very quickly, if I go ahead and just select this, and I'm going to pick by delimiter. Delimiter's the like the space that's in between, or if it was a comma, and it can kind of, usually what it does is finds it, kind of, it knows what it's searching for. It found there's spaces in between this, but I can quickly change it if it was a comma or something else. But in this case, I'm going to use it just as this. And each occurrence of the delimiter, I'll leave everything. This is pretty simple. I'm going to go ahead and hit OK, and it quickly split these. I can go ahead and rename this. So if I wanted this to be, if this was first, I can go ahead and click in these. And just rename, and I'll put last. And if you wanted to change the order, you could click and drag and change them around too. So in this case, I will leave it as last name and then first, like this. When you're all done, you just go ahead, and I'm going to hit close and load, and it's going to create a brand new tab at the bottom of your worksheet. So I'm going to hit close and load, and you can see now it opens this up. I have another table 5 here. I can go ahead and adjust the length of these here if I needed to stretch any of these out to see all the different names in here. So those are 4 different ways I've shown you today that you can split cells in Microsoft Excel. So from using the flash fill, to text to column, to using a formula, to using this Power Query, and all can be very effective. It depends on really what you're looking for. So I hope you like this video here today. I'll be putting out more Excel videos all the time, so make sure you let me know what you're looking for. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.